Hello everyone, this is Martin, and welcome to our third video on virtual production. If you missed our two first videos, I strongly suggest you go watch them right now, and then come back to watch the rest of this video. So, you have a working virtual set, with the Unreal Engine, a kick-ass giant LED wall, and a top-notch tracking system to synchronize your camera with the virtual environment. But, somehow, your footage is not working out. It still looks fake, like the bad green screen you used to do in film school. Is there something wrong with the screen? Maybe the virtual environment doesn't look quite photoreal yet? No, none of the above. Your problem is not the tech. You just need to work a bit more on selling the illusion. First, lighting. The light on your subject must match with what's on the screen. If the character is on a broad open sky area, you need to light accordingly. You can't have your subject too dark or too contrasty. It wouldn't make sense. And that's where the virtual set keeps giving. Remember the screens above and around the scene? The one we don't film? Well, thanks to them, you mostly don't need to recreate the light of your scene, as they are your scene. If your environment is an open sky exterior, then there is a big blue sky in your scene. Just project the sky in the LED screens above the stage, and here you go. The actor have a massive screen that projects the exact same light as the sky above her. And now, she matches a lot more of the scene. Street lights in Tokyo? Say no more. Let's have the surrounding screens project the neon lights all around. Everything you build in your scene can be used as a light source with these extra screens. You almost don't need to light at all in the real world. Almost. You cannot create anything with a strong direction and sharp shadows, as the screens are big and produce a soft light. So you cannot replace anything like a Fresnel light with the LED panels. Also, you might want to get creative or have more control on the light and not use your scene as it is. In order to do so, you can project other things on the screen. Using the media server, you can project video files so you can control the lighting strikes and choose exactly where and when they hit around the actors. You might want to move around some neon lights to shape reflections on your car or just to make them stronger without changing the virtual scene. You can also add a variety of video files that would be much more demanding in the Unreal scene to get a ton of crazy lighting effect. Or just build and animate shapes and colors on the panels to create a custom look. And all of that is controlled via a console at the tip of your fingers. The best part is, you can build your virtual scene with virtual lights that match the lights we use on set. For example, you could have a scene with 4 sky panels, 2 are real physical one, and 2 are virtual recreation, lighting the virtual scene. From the console, you can control the real sky panels and the virtual one the very same way. So now that you basically became a light wizard with those LED screens, everything's perfect, right? Well, something still feels a bit off. It feels strange when your actors cannot interact in any way with the scene. You need to throw a bit of real art assets in the mix. Like for regular VFX, a bit of realness will go a long way to sell the illusion. You have a scene in a desert? Have your actors walk on real sand. Bring a few dead trees close to them. Have real rocks that match the virtual scene they can touch. And that's not all. Don't you feel that place should be windy? Use a big ass fan to make people feel like they're really here. Maybe a bit of haze, so that the light envelops the scene and everything feels connected. Long story short, even with the screen, you still need to go the extra mile, so that the real match with the fake. And in that regard, the virtual set will offer you more possibilities than anything else before. But you need to prep everything first. Your virtual assets, your matching real assets, the lighting in your scene, and the light you are going to use on set, the video files you are going to use to reinforce the scene. Everything must be built and tested in prep. In fact, most traditional post work has to be done in prep. I hope you learned a thing or two about how virtual set works, and that you feel a bit more ready and excited to be working with one someday, as we expect they are a big part of the future of filmmaking. As we speak, the Plateau Virtuel is leveling up, and upgrading most of what it offers. They are building many surprises for the future, but that also means they have a lot of work in front of them. We won't be talking about virtual production for a while, but sometime in the first few months of 2021, we'll be coming back to Julien and Bruno's place of wonder to show you all the progress and new things they build for the future. However, you might have seen something else of interest on our footage. This is Jarvis, the motion control robot our friends at Spline developed. In a couple of weeks, with the help, we will tell you all you need to know about motion control technology and why it's also a big part of our future in the film industry. In the meantime, if you want to learn more, please consider subscribing. And if there is some other subject you want us to talk about, please leave a comment and we will look into it.